blessed is the man who has the God of Jacob as his help. For his hope is in the Lord his God. I love that scripture. And I, Marshall, we got to get that banner out, because we need to keep seeing that. That's a scripture you need to write on your walls, in your house, in your car. Blessed is the man. The word says, blessed is the man who has the God of Jacob as his help. For his hope is in the Lord. So the Lord is my help, and whatever comes against me, because God is my help and he's my hope, nothing can overcome me. So that means I don't need to know everything, because I got to go and see. When I don't see, he sees. Amen. And because he sees, I have everything I need. Amen. My hope is in God. And we know our base scriptures is Acts the 13th chapter. And we're only going to be there for a few seconds, just enough to say those three words. But for the sake of your notes, Acts the 13th chapter, the 26th verse. We saw where Paul was preaching to the Jews and some Gentiles alike. And he began to tell them, brothers, you sons of Abraham. And so we are on a mission. We've been on this mission for a little over 6 months, I believe. And we've been talking about from the beginning, what does it mean to be a son of Abraham? What does it mean? We know that it's a son of God. But there's so much in that. There's so much meat. And so we're going to go where we stopped at in Genesis, the 12th chapter. You can go ahead and turn your Bibles to Genesis. That's where we'll be this morning. And so in our last teaching, we talked about, we got on this mission a couple weeks ago about faith. Faith, we know, is vital. And faith is something that we can't afford to be without. Human being. Say to yourself, I'll never drink water again. I hate water. I'm not drinking it. I'm just not going to breathe. You know, I just. Oh yeah, you're going to have to release that breath. Oh yes, if you want to stay alive in this life, you're going to need you some water, and you're going to need you some air. And so in the spiritual realm, it's the exact same way. Some things you just can't do without. And so in our first two-part teaching, we talked about faith being essential. We went over that message, and there was a part one and a part two. And in our last teaching, we talked about the importance of faith. We talked about faith being bringing benefit. Faith brings a benefit to the faithful, and it also brings a benefit to the unfaithful. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. So faith brings benefit. My Lord, we can't do without it. We can't live without it. It's something that we cannot even begin to know God. And basically our salvation is predicated on faith. For the word say, by faith are you saved.
Amen.
Through grace. It's a gift of God. And not of ourselves, lest any man should boast. And so life is something, the gift that God brings, life eternal, bliss in heaven with God. Every man wants it. Every man wants to go to heaven. I haven't met too many people. I've met some crazy people on the streets over my years in ministry that say, oh, hell. They do it just to be sarcastic. But every man wants to go to heaven. Every man. But there's a vital to get to heaven. Essential. It's vital to your life. We said that word essential means crucial, critical, central, vital. And then God gave us another word for essential, which said foundational. Foundational. Faith is foundational. It's essential. It's vital. If the foundation of this building just some happenstance just cave in, And we fall in the abyss of the galaxies. We don't know anything like that. But you know about foundation giving away.
Yep.
Anybody heard of foundation? Yeah. The bottom of the car just fall out. You know, the bottom of the chair just fall out. And that foundation, you can't even use it anymore because it's useless. So your faith is essential. It's the foundation to your life as a child of the Most High God. And you gotta have it. And so we went as far as showing you the benefit, as I said earlier, of faith. The benefits. We showed you in our last teaching the benefit of faith to the ones that are faithful to God. And we told you the benefits of faith to the ones that are faithless. The ones that give up on God and they just throw in the towel. This God thing don't work. I'll just finish with it. And so from that teaching, you ought to be able to make a conscious decision of what you want. And whatever you want, if it's the faithful, then you got to be changed by what? The renewing of your mind. So this word, you got to get into.
Amen.
And so we can't be so naive. And the things of God, for many years they've been in the church, and they wonder, God, why that ain't working for me? So we can't be so naive and ponder why things ain't working when we chose to do things outside of the way God told us to do it.
Amen.
You got to follow instructions. Say with me, I got to follow God's
instructions.
So if you want the best, you got to follow the instructions of the one that gives it. Amen?
Amen.
And so we need to know that we can grow in our mindset and that we must be willing to take this lifestyle to its full potential. Faith is a lifestyle. It's something you get up and you live every day. Pretty eventually you go to work and the boss say, I don't need you no more. And so if you have not made faith your foundation and God your help and your hope, then you're going to be destroyed.
Amen.
Oh my God, what am I going to do? How am I going to... You know people kill themselves when the stock market crashed. There were many people that actually took themselves out. Why? Because their help and their hope was in their money.
Yeah.
It was in the stock market. It was in what they physically saw.
Right.
And so they weren't able to hold on to life and they gave up. And depression and fear standing right there to consume them. Okay, I got something for you. Just take this. You might well kill yourself because you know what? You lost everything. So when your faith is in God, you don't have to worry about it. Say with me, my faith is in God.
My faith is in God.
I don't have to worry about bad news.
I don't have to worry about bad news.
So this morning, we're going to talk about experiencing God equals focused faith. Experiencing God equals focused faith. Faith. Say with me, I need a faith that's focused.
I need a faith that's focused.
And so in order to get a faith that's focused, you got to have a relationship with a God that's able to fortify you and empower you. See, you know, how are you going to believe and trust in something that you don't have faith in? I mean, you didn't need faith to sit in that chair. You know that chair wasn't going to give way on you, right? Mm-hmm. You knew that that chair is strong enough. So why would we do God any otherwise? Why would we be depressed and lie?